Let's zoom out a little bit. Like that. Let's add this image into our reference. And let's see what we can do here. So, again, let's try to match what we have so far. So, you want to match the nose, the eyes, and the mouth. But for the mouth, this is a cartoony character, and the placement of the mouth changes dramatically between shots, so I would not use the mouth as main reference, because if there is no consistency for it. Okay, let's see what's going on here. I'm trying to match the eyes, but the nose does not match at all for some reason. Let's see what we get from this view. So it's getting a little bit trickier to match this new image reference. I'm assuming that the model is exactly the same. However, the placement of the eyes does not seem to match. As you can see, if I align the head and the nose, the eyes in this one appears to be much lower, which is odd. Although, to be honest, if I look at what we have so far, the eyes here look a little bit high to what I would expect, so maybe I have the feeling that when the character assumed this pose, perhaps the animators decided to move the eyes up to increase the strength of the expression. What we want is a little bit more neutral expression like this, so let's see if by moving things around like the mouth, because chin and top of the head from this view seems to be a little bit more close to what we want, and also the nose. But the eyes are kind of, they're not where they are supposed to, so what if I bring them down and then I also move down the shape here, like so. Let's see what we get. Okay, something like this. Let's reveal a little bit more of the eyes. Like so. Again, this screenshot that we have, it's not perfectly symmetrical, while our the character that we are making right now at the moment is symmetrical, so there's that to be considered. So let's see. To have a much broader head like that, and ears. So we also want to tackle things like neck. Something like this. Now, obviously, since I've been changing the shape from this view quite a bit, if we go back to the previous screenshots, it won't match at all anymore. We need to consider that we want to have an overall shape that looks like Mr. Incredible. And so to achieve that, we're gonna have to take some guesswork from what we're doing, rather than just keep going and keep tracing things from the screenshots. Now, let's see what we're at. So we were in this front view. Let's update this front view so we can go back here at any time. And let's move around our character and see what we have. I have to be honest, as an overall proportion, I think this version is the one that looks a little bit more closer to the original character. So let's see. Front, make him smile a little bit. I actually really like this screenshot here, so we might want to use this for our target expression. And yeah, something like that. Now let's see what we can do. I'm gonna add. So I want to start refining a little bit more the eye area. Let's smooth here a little bit. And so I'm gonna smooth one more time like that. Then I'm gonna go back to geometry and set that to 512, which is twice as the previous resolution, and update. So now I have a little bit more detail to work with, and let's start by